everybody. I am going to do a video of how I make mashed potato and steamed vegetables. So this is probably one of the number one questions I get asked by you guys. So finally, I'm gonna do a video I've been promising for a while. So let's get into it. So this is not a cookie-do recipe. This is a way of cooking the mash and steamed veg that I've come up with myself over the years. So I'm just going to take a little, put the scales on. Sorry, it's a bit glaring here for you to see the screen, but I'll put the measurements and everything in the notes. I'm going to put 600 grams of water in here. A little bit over, doesn't matter. And then I'm going to put in my steaming basket, and I've got potato chopped up in here. That's four potatoes, they're quite big, so it's really testing the limit of that basket, but we'll see how we go. Sure it'll be fine. So pop that in, put the lid on, and a measuring cup. And then I'm going to cook that for 20 minutes on Varoma temperature, speed 2. So after that 20 minutes is done, I'm then going to come and put my veggies on, which I've got all prepared in my Varoma, and continue cooking the potatoes, but steam this up top. So let's check back in 20 minutes. Okay, well that just finished, that 20 minutes. But what I'm gonna do now is just take that measuring cup off and my Varoma on top. Varoma is really good for washing your veggies too. That's why I've got water going everywhere, because I washed them in there like a colander. So now I'm going to put them on for another 10 minutes. Varoma temperature speed 2. And I'll come back and check it. And it is a matter of checking your vegetables, because everyone's going to cut them up a little bit differently. So 10 to 12 minutes generally works for the way I cut my vegetables, but yours might be a little bit different. So I've got broccoli, like quite big pieces of broccoli. I don't like them, falling off your fork. I like to be able to still have a bit of texture about them. So we'll check on those in 10 minutes. See you then. Okay, we're back. Let's see if our veggies are done. So a little hot tip. When you're lifting your Varoma lid off, lift it away from you so all of that drips down into your Varoma and not down the front of your Thermomix. Turn it over and yep, I reckon they're done. So then when you lift your Varoma off, you've got somewhere to sit it like a little tray. So there we go, they look pretty good to me. So, what I'll do now is just make sure these potatoes are cooked. Flip that up. Yep, they feel pretty good too. So to get that out, stand in front of you so I'm at the right angle. Lift that up with my spatula. Discard that water. And then I'm going to pop my butterfly in. So the butterfly goes in up against the left hand side of the top blade. Then I'm going to by flipping that lid back, now I've got it out of the way. Pop them back in there. Now I'm going to put some weigh it, about 30 grams. Doesn't really matter, put whatever you want in, whatever kind of butter you want. Sometimes I make a garlic and herb butter and have that in the fridge to pimp up mashed potato. And I'm just going to pop in a teaspoon of salt, so you can just use normal salt, but I'm going to use this amazing mushroom salt that I made earlier today. Pop a teaspoon of that in. Then I'm just gonna add like a splash of milk. Now, don't put too much in because this is where we can go wrong with mashed potato. So I'm just going to put in like, 25 to 30 grams. You can always add more later if you want. You can't take it back out. So, now I'm going to go to 30 seconds. And I'm just going to go to speed 4 and mash that. I've used soy milk because we're mostly dairy free in this house, but just use whatever milk you want. Now, if you wanted to leave it a bit more textured, you know, you could not worry about putting the butterfly in, but I like it a bit more whipped up and creamy. So there you go. That's mashed potato and steamed veggies. Now you can serve that with whatever you want. I'm going to pop these into my thermo server and mix cooking some dinner on the barbecue, and I'm going to put some vegan pies in the oven for me. Anyway, let me know if you give it a try. See ya.